Seeley is mischievous. She's smart and funny. She has a very big personality. She's very tiny. But she has no idea. She thinks she's 6 feet tall and about 16 years old. Such a normal delivery. In fact, we were out of the hospital within 24 hours. We went home and she was great, smiley and happy. About 2 weeks in, I started to notice a little bit of spit up, and then she started to feel a little warm. My husband felt like we should take her to the emergency room just for peace of mind.
Me being the worrywart I am, I was like, I think we should just take her to the emergency room. And we did, you know, and I'm glad we did.
We started to see the team on Kauai at the ER running behind the glass doors, so we knew something was wrong. And at that point, they knew that they had to medevac us to Kapiolani Hospital on the island of Oahu. You go through a lot of emotions. You blame each other, you blame yourself. You're thinking what you did in your pregnancy or in your life to make your baby go through that. And there's nothing. You know, there's nothing you could do.
High-risk leukemia patients come to us because not only the expertise that our individual physicians have, but also what we can offer should the therapies that they're on not work. We take a very multidisciplinary approach to care, that we collaborate with one another on every patient. We are going to not leave any stone unturned to cure their child.
We knew from the get-go that Seeley's leukemia was very high risk, to the point that she really needed an allogeneic stem cell transplant in order to increase her chance of cure and decrease the chance of relapse. It really takes a qualified team to be able to decipher all of their risk factors and factors that are out of our control, such as a donor source.
Even though we had 3,000 people sign up to register to help save Seeley's life, we couldn't find a match, and I had to be her half-match donor.
I know that it really wasn't an easy decision for Haley and Sean to come to Seattle for Seeley's bone marrow transplant. They expressed feeling really safe here, which is huge when you're going through something like that.
Seeing Seeley today compared to where she was 2 years ago is a completely different outlook, because she was able to have that opportunity of a life-saving therapy.
The further she gets out from her bone marrow transplant, the more confidence we have that they can go and live wonderful, fruitful lives. And that's what we want for her.
Looking at Seeley today, one word I think maybe that comes to mind is strength. Yeah, no matter what was thrown at her, she always pulled through. She always did it with a smile on her face. We can't even say thank you enough.
If there was another family that was questioning whether to come to Seattle Children's, I would tell them without a shadow of a doubt to get on the next plane and come. I think it was the best place we could have ever been.